It was spectacular. It was one of the brightest things I've ever seen in the sky.
It's the spectacular sight that still has people talking and astronomers tracking more than a day later.
They were canals.
At the Monterey Institute for Research in Astronomy in Marina, experts are fielding questions we all seem to have. What exactly was that bright light, and where did it go?
The cause of this thing is a piece of space junk, mud, dust, gases, thing like that. And when it hits the atmosphere, it heats up, and of course it starts to glow. And as it glows, the glow gets bigger. And as parts trail off in this, and they extinguish themselves, but there's a long trail.
At Salinas High School, students gathered for their weekly Thursday night viewing of the skies, where their astronomy teacher says the fireball we saw Wednesday could have been as big as a small car.
Large ones will shatter because there's so much difference in the pressure of the front of it versus the back of it, and it causes them to break. Mm-hmm. And I've seen videos showing it in at least two different pieces.
Some students gathered around the telescope say the sky came to them.
Last night we were at band practice, and we turned around, and out of the sky was this like bright flare of just fire that struck. It just came down out of nowhere.
It looked like a great big fireball that was just going through the sky, and it was really cool because it was bigger than most like shooting stars that you would see, but it was really cool because it had a trail.
This is the Salinas Meteorite Museum. The fireball that was seen last night would produce chunks like this that would have smashed most likely into the ocean.
Where the meteor went now is what has treasure hunters searching in the Martinez Hills.
Meteorites are very cool. I don't know if you've ever held one, but it's a Oh, I would love to hold one again, especially one that's come hurtling out of space to blow so many people's minds.
No luck for the searchers today, but by this map of the meteor's reported sightings, it may be days or even weeks before a more precise location is pinned down.
I've been talking to people all day, and they give wildly conflicting reports of where it was going and what time it was and how high it was.
But there may still be opportunities for folks to get a glimpse of the meteor if they missed it last night, or maybe get somewhat of a semi-repeat performance throughout the weekend. Astronomers and experts tell us that the best time, probably this weekend, to get a look at the meteor shower that's expected is probably the Saturday night, but probably after 10 o'clock or so. Things get really dark. They say head out to a place maybe like off of River Road or even in Pacific Grove where things are a little darker. You can let your eyes adjust and then you can take it all in, guys.
All right. Bring a sandwich.
Thank you, Brittany.